this is Frances Herdes. Today with a rather unusual topic. A friend and I, Birte, we were just talking about spearmint. And have you ever experienced when you talk to someone who might have been well-dressed or might have had a high status or who might have just been nice to you, have you ever experienced that you had to hold your breath because what the air coming out of the mouth of the person speaking was so stinky that somehow you wanted to be nice, but somehow you rather wanted to cover your nose because it didn't smell so good? Well, it's a rather unusual topic, and I get to it because I find it such an important topic. I mean, there's so many successful, well-dressed, very nice people out there, and it's so important that the fragrance of our body is in alignment with our health and wellness. And yeah, you know, there's a saying, you can either smell someone, or someone is very fragrant for you, or someone really repels you by their smells. And I find that a very interesting topic. I don't know exactly how the saying is in English. Maybe you can help me out here in the chat box. But it's a German saying that some people who you really like, they are very fragrant for you, and you hold them near you, and you like to meet them. And some people you just cannot smell, and you just keep them at a distance. And it happened to me a few times that I just have to hold my breath or want to cover my nose when I talk to someone. And it's interesting, if that ever happened to you, you can comment here in the chat box. And I'm not doing it to denounce someone or to talk bad of them, but because it's such an important topic and we can do so much about it in a natural way. So it's interesting that those people, they are not even aware of how they smell, because they are in the smell the whole day. It's like their microbiome, and they don't even know that it might be uncomfortable for some people. So just having talked about spearmint with my friend Birte, there's a recipe for a mouthwash. I do a lot of things myself because I don't want to have all those synthetic chemicals in what I put on my body or inside my body. And spearmint is a very good essential oil for creating your own mouthwash. And many people know the fragrance of spearmint from chewing gums. And chewing gums, if you eat too much of them, you can land on the toilet because they have, I think it's called xylitol, which can really give you a moving experience. So let's not have that when we just want to have good breath. And in many chewing gums, there's synthetic spearmint in there. So why not go back to the roots and take the all-natural solution? If you have an all-natural spearmint essential oil, you can put a drop in a glass of water and you can just, you can wash your mouth with it. Sorry for my English today. So it seems to be all over the place. You can rinse your mouth, you can wash your mouth with it. And there's even a special recipe I use with cinnamon and eucalyptus and peppermint. And I really wash my teeth and my gums with it. And this really gives me a fresh breath and a lasting fresh breath. It's unlike many toothpastes or many chewing gums. It really creates a lasting experience. So this is one way we can improve the smell that comes out of our mouth. And if there are people around you where you really have to hold your breath, where it really is uncomfortable when you talk to them, and otherwise they are very nice people, you can just say to them, "Hey, do you want to try my mouthwash recipe?" Just in a very nice way. As I said, it's not to talk bad of those people, but some people don't even realize how bad it stinks when they talk. And then talking to Birte about Spearmint, there's a level deeper we can go when it comes to our mouth smell or mouth fragrance, because it all comes from your guts, really. How do you cleanse your guts? Now in autumn, especially the months of September and October, but also in spring, February, March and April, those are excellent months to really do a gut cleanse, or especially a colon cleanse. Because, of course, the air, which is so bad, comes from the inside, from your guts. So what I do is, twice a year, I do a colon cleanse. And I use natural plants. I have a special recipe with plants and essential oils for that. And because many people are asking me around this time of autumn and also in spring, I put together a webinar for that. You find it on my page, livefragrantly.com/webinars. And just look for the inner cleansing webinar for the colon cleanse, because if you take the right plants, they can act like a cleaning brush inside your guts, and they can really help you to restore your microbiome. And then, of course, you can build up your microbiome with good bacteria, which are, for example, in kombucha, or kefir bacteria, or I have my to-go bacteria when I'm traveling. They are called Life 9. And I sometimes take those cultures in capsules. But when you do that, you have to be very careful that the cultures are the right ones, so they arrive at your guts, at your colon, living. So all those probiotic drinks and stuff, many of those cultures, they are being killed by your stomach acid. So, this is where the smell from your mouth comes from. And in order to not have to hold your breath when you talk to someone, just take that person by the hand and say, hey, let's do a colon cleanse this autumn together, or in the next spring. And I was amazed, because I've been giving workshops for a few years now, since 2012, or even longer, I think. And I accompanied many people on their journeys to inner cleansing. And it's very interesting how the body fragrance changes when you do an inner cleanse. How the smell of your breath changes when you do an inner cleanse. And even when you're sweating, the smell changes when you cleanse your colon, when you use essential oils in your mouthwash. So, just as a little inspiration, today I invite you to my inner cleansing webinar. You find it on livefragrantly.com/webinars, because I find it such an important topic that people smell good. And you know, when you feel fragrant, then you have a whole different kind of self-confidence as well. When you always go around with a feeling, oh, I could smell bad, or what kind of impression do I make on such and such person, then you might get anxious and not really step into your self-confidence. So that's another important topic about that as well. So yeah, just go over to my page if you like, and I give many fragrant tips also, how to release stressful thoughts and emotions, especially when we go inside more now in autumn, when we are inside, when we are reflecting more, when it's getting dark at night. Also, I show you how to relax your body and how to realize your highest potential. And that's where body fragrances and also inner cleansing comes in, because you can only have your full energy level when you cleanse regularly. So, just a little inspiration, you can sign up for my free videos on my page, livefragrantly.com, and I'm looking forward to meeting you there, and looking forward to meeting you in a very fragrant way, And just let me think here in the comments, just let me see if you have ever experienced that you had to hold your breath when someone was talking, or if you have ever felt uncomfortable when you were sweating, or what kind of odors your body gave away. So yeah, just let me know in the chat box. Such an interesting topic. Many people keep silence about because it's somehow might be embarrassing or not the right topic to speak to when you speak to someone nice, but it's so important, I think. So just let me know what you think about the topic here in the comments, and I'm looking forward to taking you on that fragrant journey in the webinar and in the video on my page, livefragrantly.com. All right, have a wonderful and fragrant evening or day wherever you are. Fragrant greetings from Hamburg, and I'm looking forward to meeting you in the next video. Until then, happy implementing, happy experiencing.